my aim in life was to save people. So that was the reason why I joined helicopter stream. So I achieved my aim in 1999 in during Gujarat cyclone. I rescued a few people and got the chief of aircraft commendation medal for that. So after my aim in life was achieved, I was looking for something else. So instead of saving lives, I changed to making lives. Now I help people achieve their aims. That is my aim in life. So I left Air Force in 2006. I did my MBA from XLRI. Then I joined a company called NIIT. Heard of NIIT?
Yes, sir.
Anybody wants to join NIIT? No? NIIT is not in the list. Anyway. So from NIIT, I joined a company called Shaurya Aeronautics and I was the vice president of the company for 2 years. From there, we started a company called Shaurya Flight Sim. That is the first helicopter simulated company in India. After doing that, I started my own company called Inspire Human Potential Development Limited. And I have written this book. I'll leave the book in the library if anyone wants to read it. The good thing about this book is the foreword has been written by a world-renowned author called John Harichandran. He is the guru of authors like Deepak Chopra and Robin Sharma. So enough about me. The aim of this lecture is to lay a foundation for the personality development program that we will conduct in the next 6 weeks. And the other more important aim is to know each other better. So I want to know about you. I want to know about your aims. I want to know about your ambitions. I want to know about your dreams. I want to know about your desires and your fears and your doubts. So my first question is, how many of you want to succeed in life? Everyone, so yes, your reluctant manner should come automatically.
Yeah, okay. It's in recording mode. It's in recording
mode. It's in recording
mode. Okay.
So what is success?
Anybody? To cross limit of a dream is called success.
Okay.
So to achieve the predetermined goals set up by himself or person, an individual.
Okay.
So which is justifiable, the predetermined goals that you have and you succeed and it is justifiable.
Yes, that is correct. So success is a progressive realization of a worthy goal. You can't say, I've succeeded in eating 8 eggs in one time. That is not a goal. It should be a worthy goal. So how many of you have goals? How many of you have aims in life?
Okay, first the cameraman. What's your aim?
My aim is to be very successful. Whatever I do, I should succeed. I should touch the sky. Okay, and mainly I want to do my own business. I'm having my own father's business entrepreneur. So I want to take it to the heights. Okay.
Okay, that is good. Anybody else? Aims. No aims. What is the aim?
So I want to be a successful citizen. Apart from that, I want to be a successful man in life and whatever field in every and whatever I want to achieve in my field. That is in the field of management. I want to be in the top position at the zenith.
Yeah, that is a good aim. So what is the first thing that comes in mind when you talk of aim?
Dedication, sir.
Any story that comes into mind? Heard of Arjun?
Yes, sir.
Arjun and the aim. What is the story?
He's rotated on a circle and it is asked to aim that in his eyes, in that fisher's eyes.
Okay.
And that is rotating, that means it's not fixed.
Okay.
You have to aim in that position.
Yeah, your aim should be clear.
Yes.
So first thing, when you want to achieve your aim, the what? you should be very clear what do you want to achieve, and how many of you know you are powerful to achieve your aim? You are very powerful and intelligent to achieve your aim. Powerful. Okay, let's consider power first. Anybody from biology background? So, what is mitochondria?
So, powerhouse of the cell. It's called powerhouse of the cell.
It's the powerhouse of the cell. So, how many cells are there in the body? Trillions of cells. So, if trillions of cells are there, each mitochondria produces microvolts of energy. So, how much does your body produce? It produces trillions of cells, trillions of microvolts of energy. You won't believe if we have the power and the capacity to, you know, harness the energy that we have, the power that we have, we can light up the entire city. So, you have the power to achieve your goal. And next thing you require to achieve your goal is intelligence. So, who can tell me which is the best computer, laptop or a desktop? You can take the book. Yeah. Which is a better computer, laptop, desktop?
Laptop, sir.
Which is the best laptop?
Dell.
Sony, how many GBs?
Hmm?
500 GB. You know, you are blessed with the best computer, every one of us. It's called the Nectar computer.
Yes, sir.
Your brain is the best computer. You know, how many GBs are there in your brain? More than 80 million GBs. So you have the power, you have the intelligence. So the next thing required to achieve your aim is, why do you want to achieve it? Have you watched JD?
Yes.
So no, very good. You're like me, I don't watch TV. So what does the commissioner tell them every time? There's some crime is there. What does he say?
Kushto
Garbar. What is the motive behind the crime? Okay. So what is the motive? You know, you should be very sure whatever is your aim, what should be your, why do you want to achieve it? Suppose you want a job. And for the aim also you should be very clear. If you want to, you know, join Reliance, what post you want to join? And what do you want to do after joining, you know? What should be your aim? So, your motive should be very clear. Motivation is motive for action. So, what drives you to achieve your aim? I'm sure you have, people will be here who have given, you know, taken education loans to attend this course, right?
Yes.
So, your first aim you should be, your motive should be to, you know, clear the loan as soon as possible. And second thing you can have is to have a better lifestyle for your parents. So that your motive should be very clear. What is your motive behind your aim? So after what? Everything comes with a time limit, right? Your electricity bill, you have a time limit to give it. Your phone top up, that has to be done with a time. So with your aim, you should have a time limit. Okay, I'll achieve so and so aim by so and so day. So and that should be, you know, achievable and practical for you to achieve. So the next thing is, how do you want to achieve it?
So through dedication towards the goal, or work, or by hard work.
Okay, that is correct. There is no substitute for hard work. You know, how many seconds are there in a day?
36.
No mathematical genius here.
Per day.
It's 86,400 seconds. Okay, I have calculated, confirmed. So everybody, every one of us is blessed with the same number of seconds every day. We have it like a kitty, you know, like a bank. Every day it is 6,400 seconds are deposited in our kitty. And how we use the time is what differentiates between a success and a failure. So I'll request you, you know, if any one of you is watching TV, you know, mindlessly, you know, from one serial to another, from other serial to another, you can stop that. Use your time very wisely. You will realize it later on when you come to my stage, you know, if you respect time, time will respect you. So every day when you get up, you have your goal, what you are going to do today. What is the one thing that you are going to do to take you towards your goal? So have this thing very clear. And once you are sleeping, you should understand, have you achieved your goal or not? Clear? Okay. So we have the what of the goal, the why of the goal, the when of the goal, and how of the goal. To give you an example, when I was working with a company called Shaurya Flight Sim, there was a person called Mr. Madhukar Parikh. He used to come to the company. He was the MD of a company called Millennium Aerodynamics. So about him, it was said that he is the best salesman in aviation industry. He used to be out for 20 days in a month abroad making deals, and for him to earn, you know, for him to get a deal of 5 crore or 10 crore was an everyday business. So I really wanted to, you know, make friends with him and learn about salesmanship from him. So he had come to us because he wanted to learn helicopter flying, because his company Millennium Aerodynamics was made the authorized agent for HAL. You know HAL? Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. HAL has made this helicopter, the only Indian helicopter that has been made. It's called ALX, Advanced Light Helicopters. So he came to us to learn flying just because he thought that if he learns how to fly helicopters, he'll be able to sell the helicopters better. So we became good friends. He taught me a lot about salesmanship. So once we were talking, so I just asked him very casually, sir, you are out, you know, in a month you are 20 days out away from your family. So what is your purpose in life? What is your aim? So he said, my aim is to get business for the company. I said, that is the aim of the business. What is your aim? What is your purpose in life? You know, he was a 52-year-old man. He was silent. This is my bad habit, you know. If you, you know, see me more often, I'll poke everybody to, you know your aim and, you know, strive towards it. So I asked him the same question point blank. So what is your aim in life? So this 52-year-old man was silent. He was silent for good 2 minutes. He said, I am 52-year-old and I don't know what is my aim in life. But give me a day, I'll find out and I'll let you know tomorrow. So next day he told me that his aim in life is to have a CTC. CTC, you know? No.
Package.
Everybody is working towards package. So CTC is cost to company income. It's your annual salary plus your perks. That is your CTC. What the company is being costed for your, you know, for your employment.
Annually.
Yeah. So he said that my aim in, I have decided that my aim in life is to have a CTC of 1 crore. So I said, how much was it then? He said his CTC was 65 lakhs at that time. Then I asked him the next question, why have you chosen the same? He said, I have chosen the same because my son is also a chartered accountant like me, and I want to set a benchmark for him. That he should think that if my father has achieved 1 crore, I should also achieve either 1 crore or more than that. So I said, that is a noble aim, right? It's a worthy goal. So I said, I asked him the next question, when did he think that he will be able to achieve it? He said that we are talking is August 2009. And he said that by 2015, he will retire. By 58 years, many people retire in the industry. So he says, by 2015, I'll retire, and by then, I think I'll be able to achieve it. Then the next question I asked him, how did he think that he'll be able to achieve it? He said that if I keep getting business for the company, my boss will keep giving me increment for 15 to 20%. That is the company, that is the general industry standard. And by the time I retire from 65 lakhs, it will get down to, it will go up to 1 crore. I said, very good. Then I asked him the next question, that have you ever written your aim? Any place you want to go to Patna, you got to have a ticket. Where you want to go to life, you have a ticket for it. Anyway, so I asked him, have you written your aim? He said that he has attended seminars and lectures where it's told repeatedly that you should write your aim. But he said he has never written his aim. So I asked him to take out his business card, and on the back, I asked him to write that my aim in life is to have a CTC of 1 crore or more by 2015 or earlier. So I told him that, you know, you go for international flights after the check-in and all that, you wait there for such a long time, you just take it out and you read it and feel it to be true. Feel that whatever aim you have written, that is true, and be thankful in advance. Like, thank your God or whatever you pray, you thank your stars that you have achieved your aim. So anyway, he was a good student, and I'm very sure that he must have done it. So this was August 2009. In September 2009, he gave me a call. He said that I'm having a party in Mumbai. I want you to come. So I went to attend the party. I knew with a zing in his voice, I knew what is it. But anyway, I just waited for him to tell it to me. So after the party, he told me that you know, he has achieved his aim. So I said, how was it possible? He said he had gone to the Sri Lankan chief to sell helicopters, but they refused to buy helicopters. Instead of that, they ordered 100 CFTs. So CFT is crash fire tender, the fire tender that I use in the airport. Seen that?
No.
Anyway, so they have instead of only water, they have foam and all to extinguish the aircraft fire. So they had ordered 100 CFTs. So this the company had an order of 100 crores. Each CFT was 1 crore, so the company had an order of 100 crores. And the company got a commission of 40 crores, 40% commission. So the company had a profit of 40 crores with just one deal. So that's what he said, that his boss, the CEO of the company, was very impressed with the deal. So he proposed to increase the CTC from 65 lakhs to 97 lakhs. Then he said, when he heard about 97 lakhs, he said, why not ask for 1 crore? So he asked him to increase it to 1.1 crore. And his boss agreed. So you see, what he thought was possible in, you know, 6 years became possible in one month. So if you, whatever I tell you to do, you know, if you do it, you will be surprised how fast you achieve your aim. So if I will ask you to write your aim, whatever you think, like, write it in the same way. Please take out your pen and paper. It's not only talking, work good. You can write in this same word or the other word, whatever suit you. My aim in life is to, you know, is to become, is to have, is to, you know, whatever. Or better, by so and so date or earlier.
to still photograph, you know.
Yes, sir.
Just bump it, low cut it.
From me.